What's up, Major friends? This is Eric from Major School. Today, we are going to look at how to migrate dashboards that are using Universal Analytics data to dashboards using GA4 data. Now, migrating your dashboards is usually a piece of cake, but with GA4's new model, you might encounter some unexpected surprises, or even end up with a lengthy chain of activities to go through before you can visualize your data. This is why we'll show you our exact procedure so you can skip the trial and error and make this a smooth transition. And we'll use a live example that you can apply to other types of migration. So here's the plan. First, we're going to map our events because we need to understand GA4's lingo to make the right comparisons and track the right events. We're going to look at duplicating our assets. This includes our dashboards, our reports, and our data sources. We're also going to look at how to recreate metrics because unfortunately, some GA4 data will not be available in Local Studio. Lastly, we are going to look at the value of keeping a record of all these changes. Okay? We also have a guide that summarizes all the steps covered in this video. So make sure to check the resources. All right, let's get started. Let's begin with mapping events. Here we assume that you've already migrated your UA events to GA4. This is important because you should note that GA4 has a new data model, updated features, and tracking capabilities not found in UA. As a result, some data points and metrics may have changed or be unavailable. To help, we have a free tool to map these events. As you can see, we have on the right side our Universal Analytics events and their best possible translation into GA4 events on the right side. Now, let's look at a more complete example. Here, for example, we have a lead Universal Analytics event, which is called Form Submit in GA4. We also have a download event, which could be called File Download, and this naming convention is borrowed from the GA4 Enhanced Measurement. To help you with these comparisons and finding suitable naming conventions, you can go to the GA4 event reference and find them here, like File Download, for example. You can also plan out your new dashboard by listing out your UA metrics in Local Studio and compare them with GA4. For example, here we have a dashboard using Universal Analytics data. The first scorecard is using the Page View metric. In Universal Analytics, the page view metric is known as views in GA4. You could go back now to your tool and add a new spreadsheet to map them out. Next, you need to identify what GA4 data may not be available in Local Studio. And this is where many users get confused and frustrated because popular GA4 metrics, although available in GA4 standard reports and explorations, may not be available in Local Studio. You can use a tool like GA4 Spy, which you should know by now since we often mention it at the Major School. Here you can check whether a GA4 dimension or metric is available or not in Local Studio. To illustrate, looking at our dashboard which focuses on user engagement, we have, for example, in this scorecard, pages per session, which is known as views per session in GA4. We also have bounce rate, which actually remains the same in GA4. Now, in GA4 in explorations, we can find our views per sessions and bounce rate. Although available in GA4, this may not be the same for Local Studio. If I was to look for these metrics, for example, in the GA4 Spy tool, let's go to the search bar and look for views per sessions. Here you go. Click on it. If you're looking at Data Studio, which was the previous name for Local Studio, you'll notice that we do not have the green check mark, meaning that the metric is not available in Local Studio. If I was to look for these metrics in this GA4 data source, like views per sessions, you'll see that we have no matching fields and zero results. Same for bounce rate. Now that you're tracking the right data from UA to GA4, and that you know what you can use in Local Studio, we can proceed to duplicate our dashboards because rather than recreating them from scratch, you can simply copy them. Ideally, you simply go to File in Local Studio, then click on Make a Copy, and then create a new data source. But before replicating a dashboard, it's important to consider a few very important factors. First, access. If you are overseeing analytics projects, ensure you have the appropriate access to avoid losing data due to turnover or deletion. We've seen this a couple of times when the authors of a report leave an organization and can be reached, or when they decide to clear up their space and delete dashboards they don't find relevant anymore. Additionally, for those working with UA, you may be aware that after July mid-year, Universal Analytics will no longer process data. But that's not all, because after that, you'll have 6 months to export historical data before losing access to UA and its interface completely. As mentioned in the article, after this future date, you'll no longer be able to see your reports in Analytics in the interface or access your Universal Analytics data via the API. So even if you're trying to make a copy of your dashboard, you may be encountering problems. Now, to have access to a report in order to make a copy of it, you can go to Share, and then here you will add your emails. Make sure at the minimum to have viewer's permission. Another solution would be to use a company's email rather than a private email. Now that we have the right access, we need to look at what connectors we can use to finally copy our reports. Again, to make a copy of a dashboard is very simple. You could simply go here to File again, make a copy, and we'll be prompted now to create a new data source. Now, if your data source is available, just select one, but usually you'll go to Create a data source. And logically, we could use the native Google Analytics connector to achieve this. Now, an issue that many of you may face is the following. We'll add this to our report. Click Copy Report. And you may be welcomed with all these errors. The reason for these errors is because quotas have been enforced to limit the number of requests you can make to GA4 servers. A request is simply you asking GA4 for information. In the context of Lucas Studio, loading a chart, using a filter, calculations are all requests, which can quickly exceed the limits. This is why we'll quickly look at what connectors and methods you can use to overcome these issues. Let's have a quick look at connectors, and all the options that you see here include free connectors and paid connectors. I'd like to preface, however, that most of your problems will simply be fixed with paid connectors, and there are a few good options out there. There is the 2-minute reports, which includes a Lucas Studio product so that Lucas Studio can connect directly to GA4 and avoid quota limits. This also comes with attractive pricing options. Another great solution to avoid hitting your quotas is to use Google Sheets, and let's see how this works. So, by using the Google Analytics connector, Lucas Studio fetches data directly from GA4, and therefore you have to obey the request limits. Of course, if your reports and dashboards are not too complex, they will not break. But again, if you start adding charts, multiple users, filters, etc., then you will most likely run into the errors we saw earlier. What we can do instead is to export the GA4 data we need to Google Sheets. And if we need to update the data in Google Sheets, we can send requests to GA4 maybe once a month, or once a week, or as needed. So we are doing everything in one shot. This way, we are limiting the number of requests, the number of times we are hitting the GA4 API. Since our GA4 data is now stored in Google Sheets, we can use Google Sheets as a data source for Lucas Studio. You can now manipulate your data, add charts, filters, etc., as you wish in Lucas Studio because it is now pulling data directly from Google Sheets. It is not pulling data directly from GA4 anymore, and therefore is not exposed to the quotas. So there are two ways that you can export your GA4 data to Google Sheets for free. Now you can use, for example, the standard GA4 reports by going to the share icon here and click on share this report, and then select download file, and then select download CSV, and then upload your CSV to Google Sheets. You can also use explorations for that. So in explorations, go to export data, and then click on Google Sheets. Now, be careful with explorations because there can sometimes be discrepancies. Also, there's a caveat because you can export only a limited amount of dimensions and metrics with explorations. Now, you may not run into this problem with a paid connector like the API connector for Google Sheets from Mixed Analytics, and also it will allow you to format the data to be suitable for Lucas Studio. However, Google Sheets also has limits. Google Sheets performance can start to be slower around 40 to 50,000 rows. As a general rule, if you are using more than 100,000 rows, consider using BigQuery instead. As for BigQuery, this option is free and great if you have a very large website and need raw or unsampled data. You don't have to become an expert, but you'll have to learn a bit of SQL to run your queries. Also, most people will not meet any cost, and if you do, they should be quite low. But that's if you know what you're doing. There's a solution involving using BigQuery with a paid connector that can build SQL queries for you so you don't have to learn it. It's very useful, but comes with a price tag as you can see here with Analytics Canvas. Alright, now that we have covered connectors, let's look at how to copy reports and how to validate them. Now for our example, I will share this report with another account. I'll just paste the link here. Alright, as you can see here, I'm on a different account. And you can also notice that I only have viewers access. I cannot edit this report. To make a copy of this report, go to More Options, click on Make a Copy. Now you'll be prompted to create a new data source. Click here. And if you have an existing data source that uses GA4 data, by all means use it. In our case, we don't, so we will create a new data source. For our demonstration, I'll be using the Google Analytics native connector. Select your GA4 account and click on Connect. Again, in your situation, you may be using a paid connector or maybe Google Sheets or BigQuery. Now, let's add this to our report. Click on Add to Report. Then click on Copy. All right. Great. We have now copied our report successfully, and this new report is actually using GA4 data. I'll edit this to make sure that there is no confusion. Now, I'd like you to understand why it is important to validate. In front of us, we have the new dashboard using GA4 data. In the other tab, we have the one using Universal Analytics data. You may have noticed that some of the title components have changed. Lucas Studio is smart enough to do the heavy lifting for you by doing its best at replacing your UA dimensions and metrics with those that make the most sense in GA4. For example, the Universal Analytics metric called page views is known as views in GA4. Our new copied dashboard has successfully replaced it with the right metric, views. But don't put too much faith into that. Look at pages per session, for example. This metric is known as views per session in GA4, but notice that GA4 replaced it instead with conversions. Same with bounce rate in Universal Analytics. GA4 replaced it with event count. Remember that these metrics, although available in GA4, are not in Lucas Studio, and what Lucas Studio will do is just replace it with anything if it doesn't find the right equivalent value. This is why you must check that everything matches. Now, what can we do to replace missing metrics like views per sessions or bounce rates? Going back to our migration plan, this is where recreating missing metrics comes into place. Our Lucas Studio foundational course goes into this a bit more deeply, but here's a quick solution. We can go back to our GA4 Spy tool and let's look for views per session. Click on it and make sure that the metric is actually calculated as it is confirmed with the check mark. Now, if you look at the calculation, we have here views per sessions. So we can create now a calculated field and add this calculation in. Let's add a calculated field. Let's name our field. Here, I'll add our metric, views, divided by sessions. Let's click Save. And finish. Let's look for our calculated field. There you go. And I'll drag this into our scorecard. And here is our number. Now let's take our validation a step further by first looking at the correct date range. Let's go to the properties panel, select our scorecard, and in the properties panel, find the date range, and we are looking at the last 28 days. We have 4.98 for our views per session, which is confirmed by going in our explorations in GA4, and you'll notice that we have also the same number right here. And lastly, let's look at the value of record keeping. Here, we are keeping a database of changes, where I can add notes and also references for any changes that can affect our Lucas Studio reports. Record keeping provides a clear record of who made what and when. Suffice to say that it is great for troubleshooting or future references as you have a detailed history of activities related to the migration. Alright, as you can understand by now, migrating dashboards can in some cases require quite a few considerations. We come to the end of this lesson, and if you found this video useful or have any questions, please feel free to let us know. In any case, this was Eric from Azure School. See you next time.